back to KO Airbrushing and Design. This is going to be the third tutorial in the Chrome series. So this one is going to be the Chrome Skull. I am going to do things a little bit differently with this one. If you've been watching the first two, there's been a pretty standard way of doing it with a light source and a horizon line and doing things very standard. For the skull, I'm going to do things a little bit differently. There's not going to be a horizon line, but what there is going to be is two light sources. So I'm actually going to do a green light source from one side and a red light source from the other side, so you can see how the curvatures work with the two different light sources, instead of just with a straight horizon line, which is always going to be in the same place. So by doing, again, like the two light sources are going to give you two different points of interest, different colors, show how they reflect off the chrome surface. we're going to be working in green and red on the skull. Let me get the camera turned around and we'll get to it. Okay, everybody, and I'm back here. So what I'm going to do different this time is, like I was saying, in the first two videos that I did, I used blue for the sky color. There was a horizon line and there was a ground color. What I'm going to do this time is I'm going to use two different light sources. There's not going to be a ground, there will be no horizon line. So what I'm going to do is there's going to be a red light on this side, there's going to be a green light on this side. So I'm going to start off with the green, and basically what we're going to do is everywhere that green light is going to hit, coming from that side, that's where you're going to put your green. So I'm going to start off over here on the farthest side away. You're going to get some green in here. And then that green is going to get blocked by the nose. So you're not going to see it any farther up than that. There will also be some up here. And again, like I said, everything is going to be what you see from this side. You're going to get some green that's going to show up in here too. On the front area of the cheekbone. And then you're going to get, just move you guys up a little. Okay, you're going to get some green in that upper cranial area there. Some here as well. Oops, sorry about that. Bumped the camera with my face. Because of the angle, you'll get a little bit more in the brow on this side as well. And it's going to follow down the entire side, basically. Because of the angle, you're going to get some green across the bottom of the eye socket. Like that. And I'll go in and put in like the sharp highlights and stuff like that here yet. But I just want to get where the light's actually hitting. So you're only going to get a little bit on that edge. And then you'll get some right along the front edge of that bone. Same here in the tooth, you're going to get it along the front edge. Going to get almost disappear here. This is going to be the last one that's going to actually have any of the green. And you'll get some here. And you'll get just a touch there. Over here, you should get just a little bit right on the very edge of the nasal bone. You're going to get a good shot of green on that back one, because that's pretty much facing light. This edge again. Teeth, you are going to get a little bit of light spilling through, so you probably will get a little bit of green showing there. But that's going to be about it. And in the bottom teeth, same thing, the ones that are facing the light more are going to get more. Up the teeth here on the bottom. Same process. You're trying to pick out the green on that side again. And it's going to get smaller and smaller as we go around the corner. And that'll be about it there. Because of the shape of the jaw, this can be extended in a bit more. A little bit on this side. Just a bit though. Of this again from light that's coming in through the jaws. So you might get a little bit here too. Depending on the angle that the green is at, you might get a little bit in here too. So I'm just going to add just a little tiny bit in there on that front angle as it comes out. Going to be green light catching on the edge of some of these cracks. And same up here, you might get some catching on the edge of this one. On the wrong side of the face now. You're not going to get any up on top at all. Nothing like that. You might get some here yet, possibly on that edge of the bone there where the tooth goes in. And up here it would be on the edge of the crack. You're gonna really get for your green. But now what we will do is we'll go in and put in a nice mean light area everywhere. So once I get these hot spots laid in, then we'll go back in with the red, and then at the end I'll go in with a white and I'll really bring those to life and then hit them with a candy at the end so that they don't lose that brightness, seeing as this is supposed to be chrome. Right now, like I said, I'm just doing the spots where the light is really going to catch. So you're going to get really nice reflections and highlights out here at the edge. Keep that highlight out towards the top edges now. Here it can be right on the hump though. Putting in these nice tight reflections and stuff, that's what really gives it the chrome appearance. And again, we're just basically trying to catch the direct highlights from over there. Sorry guys, I thought you had you on there. I guess when I bumped the camera with my head, it must have moved. So basically, what you've missed here is I'm just laying on these edge highlights up the side of the face into the skull. I think you've seen most of it down here. I'm going to put one more tiny one right up at the top. Like I said, these reflections, these really tight pieces are what really give it the effect of being chrome. In here, we want a nice one. And same across the bottom of this eye. This can be a really nice one all the way across to there. Front edge of the teeth too. Super bright, tight areas. That's what gives you the chrome effect. It's just a matter of knowing where to put them. See, over in here, you're probably going to get a bit of a green along this edge of the crack as well. But only down to about there. This piece here, you're not going to get anything. Probably add a nice one that runs up from the nose. Green light. Just where you know that light's going to be hitting the brightest. actually going to bring one that follows the brow a little bit more. Shaping a little bit better. And I could actually even put one in here too. Because from the angle of that light, it would be catching here. And I can still bring this one up farther over here too. You could add one in here. You could probably add a little bit of underlight there, a little bit more there, a little bit more there. Okay. I know it wouldn't actually be able to get over there, but I'm just going to put a little bit of green in these. And the only reason I'm putting this in here is just to complement the red when the red goes in. The red's going to be coming from this side, so you're going to get a lot more harsh reds through this side of the face, through these teeth. I get all the red laid in, then I'll go back in and look at where things are going to reflect back too, because you're going to get green reflecting up there, you're going to get some red reflecting. It's going to get complicated yet here, so I am going to switch to my red and be right back. Okay, we'll switch over to the red, do basically the same thing we did with the green, just on the opposite sides now. So our red light is going to be coming from over here on this side. And there will be spots where they'll come together. So much red on this side, it's going to come away from the edges quite a bit. I don't want to completely eliminate that white edge. I want to keep that there because of the dark background. just helps separate it better. Okay, so there's going to be another bit of a highlight down here. Red all the way along the top edge of this. Edge. Again, you can run your red down a little bit on this side, fade it out a bit. There's going to be a really good catch spot right there for the light. Get a little bit of the red coming out this way, just a hair more. Just get a little bit of red showing up in here on the far side, but that's gonna be about it. Same in here, you might get a little bit of a red glow right in there on that side of the eye socket. Again, it's not gonna be much. This side of the nose, however, is going to get a bunch of red. Because this is pretty much directly in line, right? You're gonna get red all the way out to the tip into the green. Then it's gonna gradually disappear into the black. Virtually no red out here. Maybe a little bit right there where that bone turns under. That'd be it. Over here, your red is gonna kind of follow that line there too, but now it's gonna be on the back side of that bone. And same there. So So yeah, your red's pretty much finished in there now. So we'll go down into here. You're gonna get some red down here. Tooth area, you're going to get a bit more red on the other side, obviously. So your red's going to be hitting from the opposite side. Thing as it goes over, that red's gonna slowly become less as it works its way over, so you're probably not gonna have any there. And do the same on the teeth. Side. And less as it comes around to the front. Same as before. Now we just have to go in and put in the real bright areas, which we've already done in a couple of places. Probably will get a little bit of a red glow in there. You're definitely going to get red there. And you might get some red inside, so I'm just going to hint a little bit of red in there. So again, same as with the green, just some nice bright, bright red highlights. Just to complement it. Same thing on the teeth. These really bright colors just blend it so that you can tell the direction where everything's coming from. Mosquitoes are getting thick in here. Luckily, we don't have all that much left to do. So again, I could take this much, much farther. I'm going to go a little bit further here because we do have to put some red along the cracks. That on the opposite side of the crack from light source. Spots of it. Do the same in here, you go on the opposite side of the green. And on this side there might be a little bit more of that red on the side coming up here. You're gonna get it here. Yeah, there we go. should give you a pretty reasonable idea of what you can do to make a chrome skull. Again, you can go a lot farther with this if you really want to. You can go back in with black and with white and bring everything up to like super detail. I didn't put any texture in this. I didn't want any texture in it. I wanted it to look more like a metal. And right now I'm just tinting it up a little bit more in certain areas for red. Okay, so the next step here is going to be to lay in some highlights and bring some contrast back into this thing. So what I'm going to do in this case is we've got the green and we've got the red. I'm actually going to bring a highlight from the front and from the top. So basically I just want to be able to bring out some of these top edges here. And this will again enhance the chrome feeling. White and black are pretty much always necessary when you're doing something that's going to look like chrome. And I'm also going to do some highlighting along the upward facing edge of the crack. And in here, just because of the way that the crack is laying, it's going to be on the opposite side. And I don't want too much in here because this is kind of back in and out of the way. And this just adds depth to the crack too. Actually go back in with black and touch along the crack and make it look even deeper yet. But again, I'm keeping the white very tight because I want it to really add to the depth and the reflectiveness of the piece. I don't want it to take away from anything. And pick out any high spots that you want, where you want the highlight to be a little bit more. And going up the crack over here, like this is, because of the angle that this is at, you're just going to have little spots of white. More there. another mosquito in my face. And you just gotta make sure that where there is gonna be a highlight on the opposite side, that you do put one there. Saying that this is just basically to add some detail, more dimension to the piece. See how by putting that highlight in, now that crack actually looks like it's got some depth to it. That was the main idea behind doing that. So again, same thing up here. And same thing on this side here now. You're gonna have a highlight on that edge. I'm gonna get a little bit of a highlight right along that front piece. And even just that little bit of highlighting, you see the depth and the whole feeling of the piece is starting to change. Following the edges on some of this, just to really separate it and get some more good highlights in there. Again, just add to the reflection of the piece. See it, that little bit of white just adds so much to the depth in that, eh? Side edge of the nose, you're gonna start getting some little highlights popping out. Inside the nose, you can give it just a touch of a highlight so that it's noticeably there. Side of the nasal cavity. Again, just to make it so you know what's there, put another one up here too. We can do that. Mosquitoes, I'm under attack. Okay, highlight there, highlight there. And I want one there to pull that way, way up on that back piece. Now we're starting to get a very three-dimensional look to it just through the use of the light. Like in this case, I don't even think, I mean, I could, black would just be taking it to another level yet, but I don't think this is actually going to need black. I think if we just play the whites right, it'll work out perfectly. Bit of white in here just to separate that from that back piece of the cheek. separating it from the far side of the face there. Yeah, that worked very nicely. Still be white in here. And here. Socket on that side a little bit more, a little bit brighter like the other one. Okay. So over here on this side, it's going to be the same. It's going to be around the crack. You're going to have highlights alternating from one side to the other. And once you get down far enough, you can stop. You don't have to keep that going because that's now going to be curving underneath. So same as what we did on this side. And outline this piece again, same as we did on the other side. Okay, and then over here on the far edge, we're going to put a highlight right along that edge. We'll pop that away from the background. Put the highlight out on the flat like that. In the crack, because that's where the light source is coming from. Highlight's just going to be right along that very upper edge, and that's pretty much it. Here, it's gonna be right there. Just a little bit here. Just along that top edge. Now as we're getting up to the top here, this will be the brightest point for that highlight. Picking out that top edge, because that highlight's going to run all the way around. Bit of an angle change there, so it's going to be a little brighter there. And it's going to be definitely brighter up this way. Disappear a bit. There we go. So that upper edge is now completely separated from the back. And I mean, you don't have to freehand that if you want to use your mask and mask that off on the outside and spray it that way, you can. And same thing as all the other stuff is, I mean, this technique can be used with any medium. White highlight across the top of that green. So everything that we're doing here is making this look more reflective in as many ways as we can. We do not want to take away from that whatsoever. So down here, for example, this is going to be kind of an upper edge where we might get a reflection happening alongside that green. So at this point, it's just laying in highlights where you think it needs them to basically accomplish what you're trying to accomplish. So like in here, for example, I am going to throw another highlight that runs up the edge of the red. Picking out the edges that you want to highlight. And I mean, this is all dependent on what you're doing for your light source. And exactly how you want to lay down your highlights. Your light source can basically be any color, it can be any location. What you do want to do is you want your reflections to accentuate what you've got going on. So like in here, for example, I am going to throw in a bit of an underlight, not right down at the edge, but part way up. I'm going to do the same over here. So I'm going to underlight this side over here. But I'm not going to bring the underlighting all the way up to the tooth or to that piece there. I want that piece to stay in front. I'm going to bring that reflection actually a little bit brighter yet. Because I really want that separated from that side of the cheek. There we go. But again, I'm just going through and I'm picking out spots where I think, yeah, you know, a nice contrasty bright highlight there would work good. Ross was an airbrusher. Happy little highlights. Again, all of these are to add to the idea of a reflective surface. Sometimes your reflective surfaces are going to have pretty nice bright areas in them. That's just kind of the nature of chrome. Your reflections can be very tight edged and yet change directions. And if you want to, you can underlight this area here just a little bit too. Don't do it much. You want to keep this very light, but you might want to make it a little bit more visible. But again, not much. There, just enough to pop it away from the background a little bit more. We'll do the same on the other side. There, just enough to break that away. Okay, now we'll move down into the bottom part of the jaw. So again, because this light is coming from the top, it's going to catch right along the front edge in most cases. So we can actually just use it to emphasize everything that's already here. Keep trying to think about the reflections that you want. And how you want them to emphasize what's here. right to emphasize where the tooth goes into the jawbone. Yeah, that worked. That worked. Brighten up some of those highlights quite a bit. Because again, it is chrome, so they're going to be highly reflective. Picking out the edges of the cracks. Now we're getting closer to the back. There's going to be less highlighting back here. A little bit, but not much. Couple of nice bright highlights in there. But again, try and keep them reflective. So in this case, I'm gonna really, really brighten up that line right there. Reflection in on the next one here. And this one's not going to be as bright. Okay, so now same thing. Now we gotta highlight the teeth, top edge, but it's not gonna go right up to the gum or to the bone. You're gonna wanna bring that kinda like that. That piece of bone is going to be stopping the light from getting there. So your nice white highlight is actually going to kind of follow the line of that shadow. It's going to be the same all the way along, because even the back ones here are still going to get a little bit of light from above. Yeah, keep highlighting on the teeth here. So like I was saying, you want to follow that edge. Now the other thing I am doing here is I am very, very lightly, very fine line edging the teeth. Back there, so you gotta move that reflection out. Just underlighting the teeth just slightly. Now I got fuzzies instead of mosquitoes. I'm going to add another highlight. Just to really make the teeth reflect. Yes, again, this is up to you, personal choice. Just one more thing to make the surface look more reflective. been saying all along, the more things that you can do to make it look more reflective, the better, because the more reflective it looks, the more chrome-like it looks, right? Okay. So now down here on these bottom teeth, that top edge is going to be accentuated a lot more. And there will be less down here. Again, just want to separate those from the background a little bit so that you know there's a lot of depth there. Just that little bit of an underlight just to break it away. And you can actually add another one in here. Because there is another piece there. This area just needed, looked like it needed something still. Nothing, a couple more reflections in the chrome won't help. Alright, there you have it, folks, a chrome skull. And I mean, like I always say, if you really want to and you've got the mind to, you can keep going. You can do all sorts with this as of yet. But I just wanted to give you kind of a basic on how you can lay this out and set it up. And, and basically do it fairly quickly. I mean, you could still go back in with black and you could pop in a lot more edges and stuff like that, clean things up, and make it just that much crazier. But for our purpose, I think that works quite well. Okay, folks, so there you have it. That's a chrome skull using two colors, no horizon line, and just one other color for a highlight, being the white. Now, I mean, if you want to, you can go back in there and you can use black and add just more reflections wherever you want. That's totally up to you. But for this tutorial, that was as far as I really needed to go on that. So I really hope everybody got something out of this. Again, like, share, comment, subscribe if you haven't already. And if you have any ideas for future tutorials, please leave comments in the comments, obviously. Yeah, like I said, any questions, comments, anything like that, please feel free. I will get back to you. Okay, thank you very much, and thank you for supporting KO Airbrushing and the tutorials that we've been doing. We'll be back again in the near future with another one. All right, thank you very much. Have a great time.